Hi friends, in this session we will discuss one more stack application, that is evaluation of postfix expression. Suppose if you have an infix expression, it is easy to calculate the operator. For example, 2 plus 3, simply the value is 5. Suppose 2, 3 plus, suppose if it is a simple expression, we know the value of 5. 2 plus 3 plus 4 into 5, it is also very easy to calculate. 2, 3 plus 5 into, generally it is difficult to calculate. So in this case we are calculating these type of postfix expressions. If the expression is infix, it is very easy to calculate. Suppose if the expression is postfix, we are knowing how to calculate. For this purpose we are using a stack. So it is an application of stack. So our first step is read an empty stack. So we are reading a stack. So that means we are initializing an empty stack. Suppose if our character Hi friends, in this session we will discuss one more application of stack, that is evaluation of postfix expression. Everyone know what is the postfix expression. For example, if an expression is in this format, this is the postfix expression. Now it is easy to calculate this operation. 2, 3 plus, simply we know the value is 5. For example, 2, 3, 4 plus star, what is this value? First we have to apply plus, or we have to apply star, or between 2, 3, or 3, 4, or 2, 4, generally it leads to some confusion. To overcome this, we have to know how to implement this problem. This is an example of stack. So initially we are initializing an empty stack. First, if the symbol is, here the symbol means whatever we are reading from the input. Here the input is a postfix expression. If the first symbol we are reading is an operand, then push into the stack. Suppose if symbol is operator, push into the stack, then symbol is operator, then pop topmost, that is the top two elements from the stack and perform operation and push the result into the stack and finally the element or the operand present in the stack is final answer. So after completion of expression, whatever the value present in the stack, that is our final answer. It is very easy to calculate evaluation of postfix expression. Suppose in the form of reading expression, if the symbol is operand, push into the stack. If the symbol is an operator, pop topmost two elements from the stack and perform operation, again push the result back into the stack. So the procedure is repeated until completion of expression. Suppose the final element present in the stack is our required answer. For this algorithm, we will implement a C program. First I am reading, suppose int stack of 30. Suppose I am globally declare some of the variables. So some of the variables are, I am initializing a stack for performing operation, push and pop operations, to insert element into the stack, to remove element from the stack, and this is our input, the postfix expression. Suppose I am reading globally the main operation. So within the main, simply the first term is getS of postfix. So ignore the reading of variables, suppose ij, so ignore the variables. GetS of postfix, that means I am reading my input, my reading input. Next, step by step, for I is equal to 0, starting from, so declare the variable int I. For I is equal to 0, postfix of I not equal to backslash 0 I plus plus. Here this is the case, this condition is, we are repeating this loop, we are repeating this loop until completion of our input. Here whenever postfix of I is equal to backslash 0 means, that is the expression is completed. Postfix of I equal to 0 means the expression is completed. So we are reading until completion of the string. Now step by step, suppose ch is equal to whatever the value, postfix of I. Initially I is equal to 0. Our expression name is postfix. Initially I is equal to 0. Ch is equal to, for example, read a variable ch. Ch is equal to postfix of I, that is postfix of 0. That is, in the given expression, the first character is read, the first operand, our first operator, whatever it is, simply ch is our first symbol if I is equal to 0. After reading the symbol, if we have two cases, remember the point, whenever we are reading the symbol, we have two cases. Our symbol is an operand or our symbol is an operator. Suppose, if check whether the symbol is operand or operator, if is digit of ch, we are checking the condition digit, whether it is an operator or operand. To check that condition, if is digit of ch, it is true means our symbol is an operand, it is false means our symbol is not an operator. So if our symbol is an operand, simply push of ch, simply push of ch. Suppose in some cases, if you are using the same concept in strings, if you are using the same concept in strings, we are writing minus 48. The purpose of this one is converting characters into integers. Converting characters into integers, whatever the case, if our symbol is an operand, we are pushing into the stack. Else means our symbol is an operator. Our symbol is an operator. If the symbol is operator, what we do? So we will discuss, if the symbol is an operator, pop top two elements from the stack. So suppose op2 is equal to op of operand 2. So I am declaring op1 comma op2. Op1 is equal to pop of. Remember this point. The first operator, so the first operand is the second one. The second one is the first one. Op2 is equal to pop off. Op1 is equal to pop off. I am reading two topmost operands. So first completed. And rest case is perform operation. Perform operation on the operands and push the result back into the stack. So after reading the operands, now our aim is push the operation. Sorry, perform the operation. Switch off ch. Here ch means either plus, minus or anything. So here plus to minus means that is a character. So in this case also I am reading string as a character. That's why I am using minus 48 to convert into a number. Switch off ch, case plus. Simply, if our operator is plus, push off. OP1 plus OP2, break. Case, suppose some examples, case minus, push off, OP1 minus OP2. So how many number of operators you required, you write all the cases. Remember the point, I am writing OP1 minus OP2. So the first reading character is OP2 and the second reading character is OP1. This is the switch case and total completed. This is the operation. Simply we are reading the expression from symbol by symbol. Suppose the first expression is symbol. If it is a digit, then push into the stack. If it is a digit, then push it to the stack. Else means it is not a digit. If it is not a digit, pop the topmost two elements. The topmost two elements assumes as OP2 and OP1. Perform the operation based on symbol. Suppose if our operator is a plus, perform addition operation, minus, subtraction operation, division. Whatever the operator, we are perform the operation and at the same time push into the stack. So here the two functions are push and pop. For example, push means void, push of int x. Suppose to push a character or to push an integer x, simply stack of plus plus top is equal to x. Initially assume another variable int top is equal to minus 1. We are pushing x into the top of the stack. That means whenever we are calling push of this one, whenever we are calling this one, this function calls this one. It pushes the ch minus 48 into the stack. Similarly, pop means into pop of means return stack of top minus minus. This is the function of pop. This is the C program for evaluation of postfix expression. In the next session, we will discuss an example of how to evaluate the postfix expression. Thank you.